Hello and welcome. This is Neil Honeycomb with EPS Foam Pro. Thank you for joining me. I just want to give you a quick history of flotation with expanded polystyrene. Now, as a lot of you know, when you go out to the beach, you see people with surfboards, you see people on boogie boards. And I'm sure you know that most of those are made out of expanded polystyrene. Now, especially surfboards, boogie boards, some of the boogie boards are fiberglass, but if you look closely, even though it's colored with different colors, it's expanded polystyrene. Now, what people don't realize is you can float buildings on top of it, houses and commercial buildings and restaurants and restrooms and all kinds of stuff. You can float roads on top of the water. And because of the uses, the different uses becoming, you know, more dangerous. If you go surfing, it's pretty dangerous, but when you have to drive an army truck across the water on top of foam, then there has to be some kind of regulations for it. So the EPS foam for flotation was really used, started being used in the 1960s. And at that time, there was wood. Wood was being used to float, and empty drums were being used. But they found out that the expanded polystyrene, you could float a lot more. You can float about 55 pounds a cubic foot instead of like 18 or 19. With the wood. So at the time when they started using expanded polystyrene, they were giving it about a 20 year life guarantee or expectancy. And then what they found out was that in the 1990s, if you take the foam and you encapsulate it, it just lasts a lot longer. So the Army Corps of Engineers, they actually came in with recommendations, and they started regulating the expanded polystyrene used to float buildings and other kinds of structures. So they came in and they actually established a water absorption test for the American Society of Testing Materials, ASTM, and that's a water absorption test for expanded polystyrene. It's also for other types of flotation, but the expanded polystyrene has to go by that. Today you have to have an ASTM standards test, you have to have a Hunt's test, it's also a water absorption test, you have to have Army Corps of Engineers approve it as far as the type of coating you put around it or encapsulation. It has to be encapsulated. Just a few years ago, you didn't have to have it encapsulated. And then what happens is the sun and the wind and everything else, the outside elements would destroy the foam. But if you encapsulate it, it lasts for almost forever. I mean, it lasts 100 years. So basically started in the 1960s. 1990s, the Army Corps of Engineers came out and they did some regulations, the ASTM test, the Hunt's test, the Army Corps of Engineers really got involved. It says here, some designs consist today of blocks of EPS with steel reinforced concrete walls and 10 to 15 feet on center top slabs. So now even, it's not just like encapsulated, they're taking concrete and they're surrounding the foam with the concrete, which makes it very, very stable. And you'll even see there's breakwater, these big concrete structures that are sitting in, it's stopping the water from damaging the shoreline, and that's actually floating on expanded polystyrene. So it's a pretty simple idea. You take foam, encapsulate it. There's some tests that need to be done, and once they pass the test, then it can be used, and there's definitely standards. I know I keep rambling on, but that's just a quick background on expanded polystyrene. It's being used today more than ever, and it's being used all over the world. I mentioned in one of the other videos, one day I'm going to build a hotel and we're going to float the whole thing on expanded polystyrene, and just watch and see it happen. I'm going to do it because you can. People are just not doing it. But anyway, now this is Neil Honeycomb. I'm signing out. EPS Foam Pro, check out my website. I've got a whole bunch more about expanded polystyrene on there, and I'll be adding a lot more as I get older. So again, this is Neil Honeycomb. I'll see you on